TextSAM is a new pre-trained deep learning model available for ArcGIS Pro. It allows you to segment any object from your input imagery using user-specified text prompts. This model expands on the existing Segment Anything model by combining it with the Grounding Dino model. To get started with deep learning in ArcGIS Pro, you first have to download your deep learning libraries. If you haven't done so already, we have a GeoSnap covering this topic linked in the description below.
To use the model, the first thing you need to do is download the deep learning package. On the Living Atlas, we can search for TextSAM. On this page, we can see a description of the model, followed by licensing requirements. For ArcGIS Pro, we're going to require the Image Analyst and the 3D Analyst extension. Below this, we have a guide that helps us walk through running this model. Finally, below that, we have input requirements, 8-bit 3-band RGB imagery. This is important because if our input is different, we can get an error when running this tool. At the top, all we have to do now is hit the download button. Once it is finished downloading, we're going to open up ArcGIS Pro. Now in ArcGIS Pro, I'm going to open the Detect Objects Using Deep Learning tool. This can be found in the Image Analyst toolbox, located under Deep Learning. For my input raster, I have drone imagery that was collected and processed into an orthomosaic. I want to ensure that it has the correct properties for my tool. You can see it has 3 bands and an 8-bit pixel depth, so I know it's good to go for our input. For our model definition, we're going to find the DLPK or the deep learning package we downloaded from the Living Atlas. I'm now going to set up my text prompt. In the value box, I'm going to type in circular objects for this example. After I finish that, I'm going to go and choose non-maximum suppression and give myself a max overlap ratio of 0.1. This will help us select the most relevant detected objects. Next, I will choose an extent that corresponds to my input imagery. After that, for cell size, I can choose one of the defaults or directly type a value into the box. For this example, I'm going to use a cell size that is larger than my input imagery. Keep in mind, the smaller the cell size, the more objects you will detect. Once ready, you can go ahead and hit run. This part can vary on your computer, but once finished, you'll have a feature class of all your segments. By panning around, I can see the different segments created. I can even open my attribute table to see a full list. So go ahead and start experimenting with the TextSAM model today to see what objects you can detect.